آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a continuation of last khutbah, talking about the signs of the Day of Judgment. And I have presented the subject of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi, al-Ma'ruf is known by al-Mahdi. Sometimes they call him the awaited Mahdi or al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar. In brief, yani, to you. But before I continue talking about the major signs of the Day of Judgment and how we should comprehend them, just a couple of remarks, because a lot of the brothers commented on this. First of all, the sign of al-Mahdi, most probably, Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi, yes, it is a minor sign, but a lot of the scholars have given it a very special name, which is the transforming sign, العلامة الناقلة هكذا يسمونها. يعني, because we know that al-Mahdi, this Imam, will lead Isa in the Salah, based on the hadith that I quoted to you, that he's actually going to be the Imam of the Muslims, and Prophet Isa will descend after he descends. And we know that the second coming of Prophet Isa alayhi salam is a major sign, is not a minor sign of the hour, is a major sign. This is one, so they give it a special name. I forgot to mention the people who rejected the idea of the Imam al-Mahdi, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. They rejected on the basis of intellect. They basically said that, you know, do not let people go to sleep, rather, you know, you should, because a lot of Muslims, they live with that notion, you know, just relax, Allah will send the Imam, he will take care of the Ummah. I mean, this approach is not correct Islamically. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent with him the companions. And Allah stated this in commenting on the Battle of Badr. Allah said what to the Prophet? هُوَ الَّذِي أَيَّدَكَ بِنَصْرِهِ وَبِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who supported you with the victory which comes from Allah to begin with, but he also supported you with the believers, with Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. Huh? Al-Mahdi is not going to be one-man show. Al-Mahdi is going to need people who will help him. Add to this, like I said a minute ago, if you do not, and this is how really these signs of the hour are not being taught for entertainment. I hope you don't feel like I'm entertaining you or scaring you. No, you're supposed to deal with them. Look, the hadith I quoted at the end of my last khutbah, hadith Abi Hurairah, fi Sahih Imam Muslim, thalathun idha kharajna. There are three major signs. If they come out, if they are here, لا ينفع نفسا إيمانها لم تكن آمنت من قبل أو كسبت في إيمانها خيرا. You cannot start to believe. It's too late. So you must have belief before what? Before they come out. Before they come out. You're getting the point. So you can't say, okay, now I'm going to believe. It's too late. One of them is the Dajjal. And we know that Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi, based on the hadith, Isa is going to pray behind him. And Isa is coming down. One of his first tasks, alayhi salatu wassalam, one of his first tasks is to kill the Antichrist. So that means you cannot just go to sleep and say, what? Oh, al-Mahdi is going to come. Nah, nobody said that. No, you have to prepare. You have to go into that. The third point I want to make, brothers and sisters in Islam, and unfortunately this mistake is done by students of knowledge like myself, is you trying to clothe the current events with the signs of the hour. Like, because what happened last week, you know, that bombing and that war, talk of war, and everybody said, okay, that's it. Nobody knows that. I'm sorry, if somebody says this is it, he doesn't know then how to deal with the signs of the hour. Listen, it's possible. It is possible, that's it. But do you know? No, you don't. Actually, as a matter of fact, I tell you right now, and I provide evidence for you, that the scenario which we have right now is a perfect scenario for Al-Mahdi. A perfect. You can't have more perfect scenario than this. Look at this hadith في صحيح في سنن أبي داود صحيح أبي داود الإمام الشيخ الألباني correct authenticated it and مسند أحمد. Look at this. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, تصالحون الروم صلحا آمنا. The Muslim world, the Sunni Muslim world, let me put it this way, will have a peace, a treaty, a covenant of peace, a truce with the West, Rome, the Christian world. Now, who's going to do this? The leaders. Listen, when we speak like this, we're talking about the leaders, the people who are heading the states in the Muslim world, the Muslim states. And then what happened? فَتَغْزُونَ عَدُوًا مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ. You and them will fight together, an army, an enemy behind you. Look at this. So meaning the Muslim world, the Sunni world, which is now they have with America, with the West, Iran, Russia, China. Perfect scenario. فتغنمون. The hadith, مش كلامي هذا, that's not my speech. It's not me. If you need the reference, I'll give it to you after the فتغنمون. And you will conquer. Well, you will be successful in that war. Oh. Then what will happen? In your way back, both armies, in your way back, in a place called Al-Ghuta, or Marj Dabiq, which is in Syria, Marj Tulul, a place in Syria called Al-Ghuta, it's known. Then one of them will raise the cross and he will say, the cross has conquered. That the cross held us. A jealous Muslim will say, no, Allah has conquered. And that's how this will turn into a religious battle between Christians and Muslims. And this is what they refer to in their books, Armageddon. They know about it. It's in their books. But our Prophet never given it that name, by the way. مجيدو تل مجيدو. I think they took it from the place. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called it مقتلة عظيمة. Or actually the name for it, the Sunnah name for it, الملحمة. الملحمة. But according to our records, Muslims will defeat the West in this battle. How will it happen? And just to show you, you see, if you don't have the knowledge, you see, signs of the hour are be to study it carefully, and you must believe in them, you must know. Otherwise, that Netflix guy is going to cheat you. That whoever, people are going to come and play with your head. How will it happen? And just to show you, now this is the position and the reaction of learned people. في صحيح الإمام مسلم يسير ابن جابر. في ضبط تاني يقول لك بسير. يسير بسير باء ورياء الله knows best. يسير ابن جابر says هاجت ريح حمراء بالكوفة. A stormy reddish thunderstorm erupted in Iraq, in Al-Kufa. فإذا برجل له هجيري. A man came running with a very loud voice saying, يا ابن مسعود قامت الساعة, يا ابن مسعود قامت الساعة, يا ابن مسعود قامت الساعة. He's talking to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Ya ibn Mas'ud, the hour is here. Basically, he thought this weather changes. Look at ibn Mas'ud. وَكَانَ ibn Mas'ud مُتَّكِئًا. He was reclining. فجلس. He looked at him and he said, إِنَّهَا لَن تَأْتِي. Not yet. Not the time yet. حتى لا يقسم ميراث ولا يفرح بغنيمة. Until people are not going to be able or have time to divide inheritance or joys over bounty of war. Things that they spoils of war. Yeah. And then he started explaining. He pointed like this. In Al-Kufa, he pointed to the east. Al-Kufa is west of Syria, to the east. عدو لأهل الإسلام يجمع هنا. عدو will gather here. Under, look at the details, إخوان. Look at the details, the prophetic details. Under 80 flags. Imagine, that means 80 Christian countries will gather in Syria. Look at this, the Prophet said what? In the wording of Abi Dawood, under each flag, 10,000. The wording of Imam Ahmad, 12,000. You do the math, 80 times 12. So how many are those? This is the army garden they talk about. Again, the point I'm trying to make is what? It's a perfect scenario. But can I say this is going to happen now? You're out of, I'm out of my mind if I say that. Or any student of knowledge will say, because Allah, this happened before. During the Tatar, during the Mughal, during the Crusades, everybody thought that this is the end, this is the time, this is the, it could happen. This could be another cycle, another round, or it could be the one. Again, I'm not dismissing that it could be the one. What do you need to do? You need to be ready. Ready here, hopefully you don't understand I'm preparing you for army or something. Huh? Ready with your iman for the fitan. That's time of fitna, ikhwa. Well, I have nothing to do with all of this. I wish all of this doesn't happen, but you know, it's written, it will happen. It shall be done. But subhanAllah, one of the most amazing things about the signs of the hour, ikhwa, and I love this, and I didn't read this anywhere, but this is like came to me when I was studying this. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordains that one from the offspring of Ismail, a man from the offspring of Ismail, and one from the offspring of Ishaq. They will bring peace back into earth. الإمام محمد بن عبد الله المهدي إسماعيلي مش إسماعيلي الفرقة يعني ها وعيسى بن مريم إسحاق both of them the children of إسحاق and the children of إسماعيل will restore peace in earth inshallah. These are some things that I thought about sharing with you. Here is the map quest. I don't know, or Google map, whatever you want to have, whatever app you have there for the signs of the hour, the major. So we explain now Al-Mahdi. Al-Mahdi somehow is the transformation from the minor into the major. And he will be present because Isa will pray behind him. The famous hadith, hadith Hudayfah ibn Asid al-Ghifari radiyallahu anhu. The hadith akhrajahu al-Imam Muslim, compiled fi sahih al-Imam Muslim. One day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam entered the masjid. And he found the Sahaba are sitting in a circle and studying in the masjid. The best thing that you can do, sit in the masjid, read Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked them, ما تذاكرون? What are you talking about? What are you studying? قالوا يا رسول الله نذاكر الساعة. Just to show you how they were occupied. We're studying, we're talking about the hour. That's the end of this journey, man. Wallahi, this world will perish, will vanish. They are worried about the next life. وشوف سبحان الله يا اخوة قرأت حديث والله في ضياء المقدسي وصححه حسنه أبو داود that imagine إبراهيم موسى and عيسى met together in the heaven and guess what they were talking about? They were talking about the hour. When will it happen? وشوف احنا المسلمين الآن when we talk about the hour يا رجل إيه السيرة أنت ملك you're being pessimistic talk about the concert in tomorrow who's gonna sing who's gonna win the game tomorrow Tottenham or Liverpool هذا الانشغال يا إخوة من كانت الآخرة همه whoever makes the hereafter his focus everything will go straight Allah will bring the dunya to you if you're focused there, if you look beyond this world. Imagine, I read that, okay, Ibrahim. Basically, they are asking, when will it take place? Out of respect, Ibrahim alayhi salam is the first one to speak. Ibrahim said, I don't know. I don't know when will it happen. Nobody knows when will it happen. Musa, I don't know. Isa said, I don't know like you. Amma wajbatuha. But I know that I will have to do something with it. There is something that I have to do with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring me down to earth to kill the Antichrist. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon them answering that, them answering him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah nadhakaru al-sa'a, he said to them, إِنَّهَا لَن تَأْتِي حَتَّى تَرَوْنَ قَبْلَهَا عَشْرَ آيَاتٍ It will not come until you see 10 signs before it. And this is what the scholars call them, the 10 signs of the hour, but the major. There's 100 plus minor signs, but only 10 major signs. Why they are called major? Why? Because when they happen, everybody's gonna know about them. That's why they are major. Minor signs, they could happen in a city, in a town, nobody knows about them. But major signs, it's a universal sign. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I made it easy for you to memorize. I call them the three D's. The three D's. He named them the three D's. Dajjal, Dabba, Dukhan. These, and they start with the letter Dal, which is in English what? These, the three D's. Dajjal, the Antichrist. Dabba, the beast. دخان, smoke. Those are three. Another set of three, نزول عيسى, the descending of Prophet عيسى, يأجوج ومأجوج, Gog and Magog, the two corrupting tribes, وطلوع الشمس من مغربها, and the sun rising from the west. So those are six. Add another three, وثلاث خسوف, three landslides, three major earthquakes, خسف بالمشرق, one in the east, خسف بالمغرب, one in the west, وخسف بجزيرة العرب, and one in the Arabian Peninsula. So those are nine. وآخر ذلك, and the last of these ten, نار تخرج من اليمن تطرد الناس إلى محشرهم. A fire which will erupt in Yemen, in another wording from Hadramaut, in that area, which will expel people to the land of gathering. So those are ten. Now, did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam put them in order? No, he did not. The only one that we know that took the order in the hadith is the last one, when he said what? The last of this. As a matter of fact, the same narrator, the companion, Hudayfa, narrated another hadith. Imam Muslim compiled the same hadith. He compiled two hadith for him, where he swapped the order. He changed the order. The same narrator. Yani sometimes if you get another narrator, maybe, but the same one narrating the same hadith, but with different order, that tells you the Prophet did not put them in order. So that let the scholars do their work. I don't want to, because of the time, the best work, which is legit to some extent, is the work of Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, Sahib Fath al-Bari, the one who authored the famous book which explains Sahih al-Bukhari called Fath al-Bari, huge, 12-15 volumes. Explaining Sahih al-Bukhari. He's the one who placed these in order in a very good way. But he started his work, he wrote nice, maybe 3-4 pages. He said, one of the unique characteristics of the major signs of the hour, of the 10 major signs of the hour, is they will come quickly. And he quoted hadith Abi Sa'id, I believe, في مستدرك الحاكم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, الأمارات خرزات منظومات في سلك. فإن يقطع السلك, the major signs of the hour, like beads placed in a string. If you cut that string, what is going to happen to the beads? Quickly. He said, those signs are as follows. There are three signs which will happen initially. The Antichrist is number one, who will trigger, because who's going to kill the Antichrist? Isa, Jesus, peace be upon him. We know that. Who will trigger Isa? And then Gog and Magog will break from behind that wall, and they will come out. Because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in hadith al-Nawas ibn Sam'an al-Kilabi, fi sahih al-Imam Muslim, after Prophet Isa alayhi salam finishes the fitna of al-Dajjal, Allah will say to him, حرز عبادي بجبل الطور فإني قد آذنت لعباد لا يدان لأحد بقتالهم. Take the Muslims and go up to the mountain called the Tur. There is one in Palestine and one in Egypt. Which one we don't know, but there is two mountains called the Tur. Take them up to that mountain called the Tur, because I ordained for Ya'juj, Gog and Magog to come out. To come out. And no one can fight these guys. No one can fight them. Those are the first three. Pay attention here. We know also from the authentic hadith that when Prophet Isa alayhi salam finishes the fitna of the Antichrist, and with his dua, he's going to make dua. He's going to make dua in order for Allah to take care of those. You know, at one stage, you know, Gog and Magog, these guys, you know, they're going to look around. We killed every human on earth. The hadith in Nawas also. They're going to look around. We killed every human. لَقَدْ قَتَلْنَا أَهْلَ الْأَرْضِ. Okay, let's kill the people out there. They will shoot their arrows up. Let's kill the people out there. Look for Allah to make them go through fitna. Their arrows will come back stained with blood. Yeah, I mean, the people up there, they have blood, huh? But with blood. Just to fitna. They say, okay, we killed the people out there. And subhanAllah, Allah will take care of them with a duda, with an epidemic duda, ikhwa, a worm which grows called the naghaf. The Prophet named it naghaf. It, go home and ask Sheikh Google hadith in Nawas ibn Sam'an al-Kilabi Sahih al-Imam Muslim, huh? The second coming of Jesus, or Google and Magog, whatever you want to say it. Sheikh Google is going to give you the answer. I'm telling you, huh? with a worm that grows in the nose of a camel, it's going to attack them here and it will kill all of them. And I say to the brother, and that's why, you know, there is a brother who is having a hard time comprehending the fact that, you know, Ya'juj and Ma'juj do exist now, and how come we don't see them? Ya akhi, you're missing the point. Imagine if we know where Ya'juj and Ma'juj are, what are we going to do? What the human are going to do? We're going to go dig that wall. We will dig that wall. We'll go there. That's what we're going to... You need to understand, it's the will of Allah that we don't know where they are. Because if we know, knowing the human, come on, let's deal with these guys now. Why do we let our children deal with them? Let's go. No, you can't deal with them now. It's not the time. This is when Prophet Isa comes back. Shahid, brothers and sisters in Islam, after earth is cleansed, Allah, after these individuals die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the rain to clean earth. And Prophet Isa will come down with the believers, and the headquarters of the world, the new New York, the new Washington DC, if you guys are looking for investment, will be Jerusalem. That's the head. If you guys are looking for real estate investment, go there. And that's where he's going to rule the world. The head of the world is not going to be Donald Trump. It's not going to be George Bush. It's going to be Isa, the son of Maryam. And he will rule for 40 years, based on hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood. 40 years. You know what the Prophet said about this time? I mean, if we manage to go through that trial, the Dajjal and all of this, and the Mahdi and all of this, and we're alive, you know what he said? طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح. طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح. What a wonderful life this will be when Jesus, peace be upon him, is ruling this world. One of the funny things that, you know, when we go to these so-called interfaith, I don't know that, I don't like that word interfaith, because nobody enters into anybody's faith. That question comes up, and, you know, from Christians, David, you know, they always say, you guys are here in America to apply the Sharia? Yeah, you know the word, the Sharia. I say, you know, we're not worried about that. We actually believe that Jesus will apply the Sharia. So that's, oh, you believe Jesus will apply the Sharia? Yeah, that's what Jesus will do. He's going to rule according to the Sharia of Islam. We're not worried about that.
Yeah, if you guys can enable us to apply it before, thank you. But we're not going to force it on you. No, nobody said that. We're a minority. We're going to follow your laws. That's how we should do it. That's how it should be done Islamically. Otherwise, go apply it in your own lands. Prophet Isa alayhi salam will rule from there. The Prophet says, "Tuba li'ayshin ba'd al-Masih." Ya'zan Allah, because remember, 3 years before the coming of the Antichrist, the first year, no rain. Third of the rain will be held. The second year, two-thirds. The third year, no rain. No rain for 3 years. Third, two-thirds, zero rain the last year. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, time for rain, earth will give the best of. Look what the Prophet said. لو أنك بذرت حبك على الصفا لنبت. صفا عن الحجر. If you throw a seed on a rock, rock, it will grow. Why? And this is, by the way, in the Christian literature. This is in the Christian literature. They say about, and the kid will play with the snake and the wolf. Yes, David, in your book of Revelation, it's there. It's there in their books. But you see, the Christians are confusing this with the hereafter. And that's the one difference between Islam and Christianity. We believe that the second coming of Jesus is prior to the Day of Judgment. Christians, they believe his coming is the Day of Judgment. He's going to judge, and this is the Day of Judgment. No, no, no. Of course, Jews, they have their own perspective. They still wait for that Messiah who's going to restore the kingdom of David. المملكه اسرائيل الكبرى from the Nile to the Euphrates. That's what who they're waiting for. After this period, there will be peace for 1,000 years, almost 1,000 years. That will be peace in earth. Of course, Prophet Isa will be 40 years. وفي حديث يا إخوة, authentic hadith that Prophet Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام, because some of you are confused. Prophet Isa coming and ruling the world. Prophet Isa is going to perform Hajj and Umrah. He's going to go perform Hajj and Umrah in Mecca. Muslim, he's a Muslim. The Prophet said what? 6 things Prophet Isa will do. حديث أبي هريرة صحيح الإمام مسلم صحيح البخاري يوشك أن ينزل فيكم ابن مريم. The son of Maryam is about to descend amongst you. Number one, حكما عدلا, a just ruler, fair and just, fair. ما هو يا إخوة, والله what is going on in this world because of injustice. Injustice, شوف The impact of justice, the what will happen in earth because of justice. Imagine this, a balm granite, the skin of a balm granite will shade 12 people, 12 men. This is how much barakah. Imagine, look at this, you know, we're begging you to pay zakah and sadaqah and all of this. Imagine this, a man will take his zakatul mal, the 2.5%, not the sadaqah. Please accept my zakah. No, I'm exactly. Thank you. My zakah. No. Nobody's going to accept your zakah. Because everybody has money. Huh? Barakah. Because of justice. Hakam an adl. This is one. Two. Yaksiru salib. He will destroy the cross. Isa will destroy the cross. Again, he's not going to run after each cross. This is symbolic. That formula of salvation which Paul introduced to the Christian world, and they bought it, that somebody died in the cross for your sins. I never preached it. And he will deny this in the Day of Judgment too. قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم أنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانه ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي به حق. Did you tell the people to take you and your mother as two gods? Never did. ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن أعبد الله ربي وربك. Kill the swine, the خنزير, Again, he's not going to go after every khinzir, every pork to kill it. No, this is a message, David, that the fact that Christians are eating pork is not lawful. That has never changed. The dietary restrictions which were in the Torah, Prophet Isa never changed. Yes, we know that Prophet Isa changed certain things. وَلُؤُحِلَّ لَكُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي حُرِّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ بعض. One of them was not pork. Pork was never made lawful for the Christians. So all that ready stuff that they eat in IHOPs in the morning is not good, according to this. وَيَضَعُ الْجِزْيَةِ. Here's the interesting piece. Abolish the jizya. What is the jizya? A tax paid by Christian, Jews, non-Muslims living in a Muslim country as a minority. As a minority. They pay a tax to the state, to the Muslim country. They receive service in lieu of that. This is not a tax for them to be Christian. You're free to be a Christian. You don't have to change your religion. A testimony, Ikhwa, I'm an Egyptian. We still have 10%, actually less than that, 10% of the Egyptians are Coptic Christians. Nobody forced them to leave Christianity. And they are free to worship. What is that tax for? Listen, if we are attacked by a foreign force, me as a Muslim will go fight to defend you. You're going to stay home. You don't have to go fight. We'll take care of that. Some people look at that jizya in a very negative way. It's like, nah. شوف يا إخوة حدث during the time of Umar, that the Muslims took the jizya, took the tax from a Christian land, from a Christian يعني province. And the Muslims were not able to defend them against the enemy. Umar said, I believe it's Abu Ubaidah or Khalid, one of the two, give them back their money. We can defend them. We're taking this to defend them. We can defend them. Give them back the money. فهدي. Here is the interesting piece. When Prophet Isa is in earth, no more jizya. Islam or. And that's one of the abrogation. That's actually one of the things that why you need to study. Me now, I can do this. Any Muslim leader cannot do this. But Prophet Isa will do this. And he will take care of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. And wealth will be in abundance. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواج أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. After those 100 years, whatever it is, 99, anything, finish or within that time, these minor signs which we are experiencing now, living now, will reintroduce themselves again, gradually. So the minor signs which could be repeated, killing will go back, usury will go back, adultery will go back, the things which we're living now, gradually. But in a bigger scale, but by all the sudden, subhanallah, the people will wake up in the morning and they will see the sun rising from the west. Again, some people who take a word from its apparent meaning to a hidden meaning without evidence. And they wrote a book about this, the sun rising from the west. They said what? Oh, those are the Muslims. In the West, Islam will rise from the West. Nah, Habibi, you don't do that. See, study Islam before you write that stuff. Or you speak like this. Study usul al-fiqh. The rules of how to deduce facts from a text. You cannot do this. Al-aslu fil-lafzi zahiruhu. by default, the default rule regarding a word, the apparent meaning. You could take it to a hidden meaning if there is an evidence. La, the sun will rise from the west. But subhanAllah, ikhwa, just to show you that death sometimes is a virtue. في صحيح الإمام مسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه الله سبحانه وتعالى will send a wind يرسل الله ريحا كالحرير soft kind it will suffocate the believers. Anyone who has iman in his heart will be suffocated, will die because Allah is going to save you from the final days. لأنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تقوم الساعة إلا على شرار الناس. The hour will take place on the worst of the children of Adam. No. They will go back to the worship of idols. Imagine if something happens with the Kaaba now, what will you do? What Muslims will do? Imagine during the time of those people, some guy will come from Abyssinia. The Prophet called him Dussuwaiqatayn. He will go and take down the Kaaba brick by brick. Nobody will care because nobody performs Hajj anyways. Nobody believes. So the sun rising from the west, and then Allah will send a beast, an animal, who will actually tell them, man, you're not believing in Allah. And this is, by the way, one of the three things. I said Dajjal, the sun rising from the west, and the beast. When they come out, no more iman, no more faith. So if you look at these are the order. Now the landslides and the smoke, they will happen in the midst of this. But this is the order of these signs of the hour. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who get ready. And that's the message, brothers and sisters in Islam. Be prepared. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو كعابر سبيل. Be in this world like a stranger. Stranger. I don't belong here. I don't belong here. Actually being a stranger is too much. Rather, bal here, that does not mean or. No. Rather, a wayfarer. Abdullah ibn Umar, the narrator of the hadith, he says, إِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحِ. If the night comes, don't expect to wake up for the morning. Be ready. Be ready. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن يا رب العالمين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, please do not leave after because I don't want to